Welcome back to another episode of this, guys. As you guys know, on Tuesday, PM Lee came out to say that the circuit breaker is extended by 4 more weeks. 4 more weeks, guys. That's a very, very long time, and we have 6 more weeks from now until the circuit breaker ends. And of course, Singaporeans were panicking. Everyone was going on Facebook Live watching our Akong deliver the speech. And I'm pretty sure you guys saw what happened in the comment section. So first, there was the micromanaging boss. Someone's gonna get
fired.
Someone's gonna apply for a relief fund. Mampus ka. You know what Malays call this? Malays call this kantoi. And this is as bad as you tell your wife you're at work, and then you go to a concert with another girl, and then the aerial camera capture your face with the other girl, and then your wife watches the concert. And then we saw the Tekashi 6ix9ine of Singapore. Okay, guys, you know how sometimes you see people get into a fight, and then they say, "Hey, you not happy? You gonna tell the president ah? You gonna tell the president ah?" And then the guy was like, "Okay lor, I tell." I'm pretty sure the guy that said, "I tell," it's this guy. "Okay lor, I tell." Yo, that is some next level pao to kia. You know, that is next level. He went straight to the Prime Minister. I'm not too sure if PM Lee saw it, but he went straight to the Prime Minister. Not even the SD Secure app, not even that. Straight to the Prime Minister and bow to it. Then of course we saw some people who were opportunists to try to get more money from the government. Firstly bro, if you cannot summon, means you were breaking the circuit breaker rules, which means you just own goal yourself in front of the Prime Minister. So why would the Prime Minister release another extra $600 to you so you can break the circuit breaker rules? And then lastly, we saw the hero that we all needed, the vigilante, the one that doesn't wear a cape, but all of us. I'm just saying, this guy is pretty forward looking, because if that goes through, paired with this, then all the men's circuit breaker will look like this. Okay guys, of course this announcement is gonna cause some panics, right? Business owners are panicking because their employees need to work from home for 1 more month. And then employees are also panicking because they might or might not get a pay cut or get fired. They don't know, sure. But then of course,
some Singaporeans, out of everything they can panic about,
they panic about
a cup of f***ing diabetes.
That's right guys, people were panicking about bubble tea. People went on a f***ing rampage to buy as many bubble tea as they can because the shops were going to close for the next month.
Are you educated?
Nope.
Like, it's like got tsunami coming, right? And then instead of saving yourself, right, you're going to save your dog. Wait, actually that makes sense.
Really, nigga?
Shit. Okay, it's like, it's like you... Okay, guys, I can't... The same logic as the people who went out to party for one last time before the circuit breaker. And people were saying that these people are stupid,
but ordering bubble tea is not.
You go out and queue, even though you safe distancing and shit. You were queuing with so many people to buy your last cup of bubble tea. And to the people who said that, if you're in the queue, f*** you. There's a video that was going online about a fight that was happening at Punggol over bubble tea. Yeah, I'm not too sure what happened, but I'm gonna call this guy Mr. Chulai. You know why? This is the amount of times he said Chulai.
Hey,
Bro, you try that many times. I think they confirm not gonna chu lai already. I don't know what signs I'm reading lah, but I don't think they were chu lai lah. Hey guys, please. I understand that everyone is just trying to make a living, and we don't need this type of things, guys. Come on. Okay, so there's another video of these four teenage Indian guys who got caught for breaking the circuit breaker rules. Okay, I don't know who added the music into this video, but just watch it. Okay, when the lift door opened, I actually laughed like because all of them look suspicious as Look at the guy standing behind, what the fuck? And then the lady, I think she's a bit confused on what she want these teenagers to do, because when they were about to leave, they told them to stay inside.
Sorry, for what?
No, don't come up! Get inside!
What is it?
When they started running, we finally saw what the guy behind was trying to hide. Everything just started to spill out. He was hiding a pack of f***ing beer. What was the plan, bro? What was the plan? You stand there and hide the beer for how long? For how long? And then if you guys watch carefully, if you see, after when he was running, when the beer dropped, he still picked it up. F***ing priorities, guys. Some Singaporeans, priorities is bubble tea. This guy is beer.
Wow, so cool, you can.
And I'm pretty sure you saw those memes that was done by Indian people where they rush into the supermarket to get beer and pretend that they're panic buying it. So we've come to the end of this episode, guys. I hope you guys liked it. I know 4 more weeks is a very, very long time, but it also means that we got 4 more weeks of cringy content. You guys know who you are. To the next episode. Goodbye, my friends.